Next time, prepare a yellow one for me.
Yeah.
Make sure we have a yellow one.
Yeah. Alright, yeah, okay, DJ Cleo, ato misana lu wine kumalo, barak si imi le kumi, you know, kene ki interview wa di artiste ni nsako deben malo wanyana fa, kape kwa wutisa kapaka lo kene kisa talo kanyo hore, gom ki, kuta batu wanse babu waka kum, bari hile kum, hile kum, but kisa understand the hore sinte sinte, he batu wa babu waka kum, what are they talking about, actually, what are they talking about, only to find hore bari kum, man, kum ki pina, ki muna te wandengese, so, yeah, I can remember King Lady Pinas and Corona, or even maybe the Wadi Rata. For come on, let's get up again. Mr. Hector, huh? Negative Mr. Hector, the motivator, Motau, Ken Longorana and Agafa. So, hi, by Longo, let's Elia, or hi, by Longa, who is our TUT. Isimon looks a guy. He's the right person. Oil Longor, Oka would say, and of course, Ken Oil Longor, Oil Longore, TUT, Isimon looks a guy. Mr. Hector. Alright, you know what? I'm not going to be able to get a lot of money. You know, I was so happy with Norman. Kwa nolo kuru simolo ziti UTFM. So kipata kore, unu simolo la yona kwa na kwa nkengwa kwa matomo ntomo ngore bolelo kore, kutli yang kore lefele zeli simolo la UTFM.
Eish, Sbu, thank you so much. You know, hagi fita mo kumbie no, umboni kama 2:30.
Mm-hmm.
I was just so emotional and excited.
Mm-hmm.
Because back in 1992,
mm-hmm.
20th of February, we had a first meeting, Gamu Cafeteria, just behind,
you know,
the building behind you. We had a first meeting prior to that. Mm-hmm. We had a few posters around mm-hmm. the campus where we are starting a radio project.
Mm-hmm.
And quite a few people, eh? Hole Majid Damad Valeting, Fantas Mobu, the late Fantas Mobu, Bojo Winklating, who was on Capricorn FM, Zolando Lucy, a lot of guys came together.
Mm-hmm.
They were interested in this project. And that day, little did we know that we were pioneering the first black, and I emphasize black, and I'll tell you why.
Yeah.
The first black campus radio station at that time. We were just young guys with a dream, and we had not even heard hardly any campus radio station anywhere in the world. We were just dreaming about, wow, this is a fresh idea. Mm-hmm. And what we really wanted to do at that time, there were two motives, I'll be honest with you. The Corvette motive, as an individual, was that I wanted to be on Radio Bob at that time. And then I wanted a demo. Because I was turned down by Radio Bob at the age of 17 before coming to TNT. And Bamputor Wela Skolong. And then when I was here studying, I started 91, 92, 93. So at 92, in the middle of my studies, I thought, you know, this passion for radio is just so strong, so serious, that maybe I could do something about it while I'm studying.
Mm-hmm.
And that gave birth to the idea to start Radio TNT. And the second motive, which was Ovet, this one, was that my friend Ezekiel Vilagulu, he loved music. He taught me most of the music I know. We're still friends to this day. And we just wanted to share our passion for music with the students. So those two reasons gave birth to you seated where you are seated today.
Wow.
It's unbelievable.
And you know, then the lens and thing is so on the Biamola Montemola. You know,
could be willing to have a very interesting scripture. Eric, do not despise the day of small beginnings.
Humble beginnings.
It didn't start this way. This is just too high tech.
Yeah.
What we do, we take speaker. I want to speak. I see Motau a party.
Yeah.
And tell the speaker, I need to study. So I'm going to say, I don't know why.
Yeah.
So we do it literally there. We have speakers living in the room. Related music, the system is a role.
Yeah.
Not this. A system is like a room. And then the next phase of it, then we started being joined by guys who were doing engineering. Mm. And they came in and we were, no, nakali connected the cables. Kamu cafeteria, then connected the speaker kamu cafeteria, and then the other one came in and said, you know what, with telecom lines, like telephone lines, mm-hmm. you can connect, because we started having other campuses, you know, like the one in Kotlasikwa. But you know, the station has to reach there, so we can use the telephone lines. So that's when we were attracting people who had very creative minds.
Yeah.
And then a broadcaster via those telephone lines. And then I left then in 1993, because it was my final year.
Okay.
So remember,
okay.
I came here in 91. Mm-hmm. And then 93, that's when Tibos came, Tibos Mukweli and Ashifa mm-hmm. Shaba. Mm-hmm. They came, I hired them on the mm-hmm. station. Mm-hmm. And, mm-hmm. and you know, what I like about the guys is that K94 and ICASA, it was called the IB something at that time.
Before it was ICASA.
It was not called the ICASA, it started nearly IB something, Independent Broadcasting Commission, something like that.
Mm.
Authority, IBA, something like that. So when they came in, the guys had an idea to say, let's apply for a license.
Mm.
And TNT Radio went on air, but I was gone already. But what I like is that the guys had a vision to enlarge on the foundation that we had laid, Izzy Vilankulu and a couple of other guys, Zolanto Losi, who helped us start the station in 92. That's the rich history of this station that you are a part of right now. Yes,
Buda
came later,
that
was 95, I think. Tibos started here in 93, and Ali Shabata, the same year. That's when they came.
Look at that.
I ended up on Radio Bomb at that time, which was a prestigious black
finally
station.
Finally,
Namaste. And then, you know, that's what was a story of like a movie. You know, at the beginning of the movie, you lose as a steady. So you lose at the beginning, and then at the end, you win.
You win.
I went at the age of 17, and I was told. And in hindsight, I think they helped me, because I don't think my English was that good. Go back to school and go and study. And then, and I'm glad that they turned me down at that time. And I remember Nelu Mudisa himself, the brother E.D. Edgar Ikhole, who was running Radio Bob at that time. Go and improve and then you'll come back. So I thought, you know, while I'm at TNT, studying what I was studying, I'm studying public administration, but I love radio. So that idea then, when it came in 92, was that at least let me prepare myself for what I really, truly love. Public admin will be something I fall back onto should things not work out with radio. And when I finished, 93, 94, I went back to Radio Bob. And 94, on the 6th of May, that's when I joined Radio Bob. And guess what? You know, just to connect history, right now, I'm working on bringing back Radio Bob as an online radio station, Bob HD. You know, it's coming back again.
And
a lot of people are quite excited about it, you know, that station is coming back you know, to play the kind of music that we used to play on Radio Bob at that time.
And then
at some time, after leaving Radio Bob, well, I did join Kaya FM for about 2 years in 1990. And then I branched out to do my own thing as a motivational speaker. And to this day, I mean, I came here for that today, by the way, to come and talk to students at 6 o'clock. So I do motivational speaking full time. It's my business. I speak to big corporates, government departments. And I also, you know, Sbu, as a broadcaster, this I'm saying to you and all other broadcasters on the station, that there's just so many possibilities. I operate as an MC as well, and this stems from my work as a radio, as a former radio personality at that time. That people started inviting me, and I'm one of the busiest MCs at the moment, you know, making, you know, quite some good money, you know, out of introducing people in general. But your gift of speaking can really open just so many doors for you. Just realize that. Take this serious, gents.
So that is why lena ke tsege ke ke tsena mo radiong basically ke lona ba ileng gore feletse letsa gore batho ba o tswana le nna ke feletse ke ya go sekolong for radio, because I was always listening to TUT FM. I have to go to school for this.
Yeah,
I don't know why, but I had that thing in mind, or you know what,